attitudes and perceptions that Ghanaian women have towards disability by Gabriella Fadul. Introduction. In today's world, societal attitudes toward disability almost always affect how disability is perceived. These perceptions can, in turn, affect how a person lives daily and their overall quality of life because of the value placed on productivity rather than on human beings themselves. How do these attitudes and perceptions towards disability affect those who have associations with a disability? Specifically, what does this mean for Black women? In this presentation, I will explore the lived experiences of women in Ghana that have relations to disability, directly and indirectly, and how these attitudes and perceptions towards disability have a link to how a woman in Ghana manages her health needs and quality of life. Moreover, I will be looking into how the quote-unquote making of a home impacts disability. How is disability generally perceived and portrayed? Disability is commonly perceived negatively, usually as a symbol of burden, liability, tragedy, curse, unworthiness, and/or lack of value. Hence, a person with a disability can become prone to many forms of neglect, abuse, isolation, abandonment, murder, infanticide, stigmatization, and ostracization from society as a whole, cited as Otibwedi, 2017. In Ghana, usually disability can be perceived as a curse or a symbol of witchcraft, quote-unquote, juju, within religious faiths and superstitious beliefs. In other words, disability is believed to be something that a person needs to be healed from. Religious faiths are believed to be a form of salvation and protection for many, and hence, disabled Ghanaian women can be subjected to involuntary and often dangerous or life-threatening treatments in the name of a cure and may receive health care only in dire circumstances, cited by NEPVO 2006, NAMI 2014, and Otibwedi 2017. These beliefs act as attitudinal barriers and affect the socio-economic and civic participation of disabled Ghanaian women, NAMI 2014. Due to disability perceptions being commonly negative, portrayals are deemed negative as well. For example, in some published textbooks in Ghana, disabled people are portrayed as beggars, cited as NAMI 2014. On this slide, there is a photo of Ghanaian women with disabilities and their children sitting on the ground in a crowded area. The source of this photo comes from the Focus website. How is disability perceived by Ghanaian women? Disability perceptions of Ghanaian women can vary based on lived experiences. Some disabled Ghanaian women perceive themselves to be limited by their disability because of social barriers, such as lack of access to disability support, accommodations, that is in buildings, transportation and technology, and limited quality health care, education and work, housing, and little to no financial stability, cited as NAMI 2014. Ghanaian women also perceive disabilities as something that can be, quote-unquote, overcome. To do this, Some women try and pass as non-disabled by hiding their disability and or proving their worth by pushing beyond their limits consistently due to the negative stereotypes surrounding disability. On the other hand, disability rights and culture encourage acceptance of disability, disability pride, and the push to obtain rights to services and support. However, this continues to have trouble reaching those who do not have access to disability communities, exposure, and higher education, cited as Dunham et al. 2015. On this slide, here is a photo of young women with intellectual disabilities dressed in colorful African outfits. The source of this photo comes from the Disability Rights Fund website. How is the social model of disability perceived by Ghanaians? The social model of disability describes disability as a social construct more than a problem of the individual that embodies it. Some Ghanaians believe that it is important to help bring awareness to disability in a positive way and also enable disabled people to have more access to opportunities that non-disabled people have. Cited as NAMI 2014. Quote unquote. There is a new government right now in their appointments, even though there is this disability law. Tell me which key government appointee is a disabled person. That alone could be enough motivation to let persons with disabilities aim high. If there is one person with a disability appointed as the regional minister, even a district chief executive, or a member of a board, but these things are not there, then that could rather deepen cultural perception that persons with disabilities don't have anything to contribute. Kofi from the CSO focus group, cited as NAMI 2014. Additionally, it is believed that concrete strategies can be developed to create awareness about disability issues and rights, and that knowledge about these issues will help change current perceptions in Ghanaian society, cited as NAMI 2014. Quote unquote. We have talked about all that, but I haven't heard about our own sensitization at the community, district, regional, and national levels. They need to be sensitized on disability issues. The law is there, but how many of us? I heard someone say that government institutions are aware, like social welfare, community development, and all the rest, and civil society organizations are aware of disability rights. What is the situation? Most people are not aware, so I am saying that we should equally be sensitized, and then we would engage these stakeholders at the several levels for them to come out with concrete measures that will enable persons with disabilities to benefit from all the resources we are talking about. Because they are sitting there on the shelves, referring to the resources, and persons with disabilities are not benefiting. Love from the CSO focus group, cited as NAMI 2014. Concrete strategies continued, quote unquote. What I will say is that let's create more awareness. We still have some leaders who don't know what gender and disability issues are. Most people are thinking that when we talk about disability, it's just about people who have disability and are now living with the able people in the society. We have to let people know that gender and disability are supposed to be mainstreamed in societal development. We shouldn't think that when we say gender, it's related to women. So we have to create more sensitization by organizing workshops and seminars. Doris from the CSO focus group, cited as NAMI 2014. On this slide, here is a photo of people with disabilities protesting mistreatment by the Ghana Airport Company, GAC. The source of this photo comes from Disability News Africa, DNA website. Womanhood and disability. In Ghana, womanhood is defined by several things. These are beauty, the ability to cook and clean, marry a partner, the capacity to engage in sexual relations, and conceive and give birth to children. It is believed that Ghanaian women with physical disabilities are less or unattractive based on their disabilities and cannot complete the tasks required by able-bodied women to be considered quote-unquote real and legitimate women. Living as a disabled Ghanaian American woman, I have experienced this reality. It is assumed that I am less worthy or less attractive because of my apparent disability, and I am either expected to be incapable of doing anything for myself or not allowed to set limitations and boundaries for what I can and cannot do, causing me to often take on more responsibilities, including domestic, than my body can handle. Domestic responsibilities, even taken on by women with disabilities, are not recognized as work-worthy, even though it is expected. Hence, the effort made by disabled women is ignored. Food is considered to be quote-unquote nothing and is meant to be shared, cited as NEPVO 2009. Generally, throughout the world, when women become disabled or chronically ill in their marriages, their partners may abandon them. In Ghana, this has been characterized as the marital standard, till disability do us part, or in the Akan language, Kosi se dem di, bete til yen mu, cited as NEPVO 2009. This phrase I have just mentioned is in the Fanti dialect of the Akan language. The original word or phrase provided in the text was quote-unquote atafwa, which has two different meanings in the Akan languages, Tri and Fanti. Additionally, when a woman gives birth to a disabled child, it is seen as legitimate grounds for divorce. The father of the child blames the wife and sees her as an inferior woman, distances himself from the child, and looks for another woman to bear him non-disabled children. In other words, the woman is given full responsibility for the couple's fertility, and quote-unquote, normal children are a requirement for continuing a marriage, cited as NEPVO 2009. The perceived inability to be a quote-unquote real and legitimate woman, according to Ghanaian standards, plays a role in not allowing Ghanaian women with disabilities to partake in decision-making. For example, quote-unquote, like if you are a disabled person, no one takes whatever you do or say serious. You don't even form part of the decision-making process because they will say you are disabled and your whole being is affected by the disability. Joyce from a government agency, cited as NAMI 2014. Quote unquote, some people think that women with disabilities are incapable of doing any good work. It's only when you are lucky and someone comes to test you and you pass the test that they may bring many more people to do business with you. When they trust you, they will come. Those who don't trust you will not come because they will think you can't do the job. Similarly, when you are looking for a job, those who trust you will try you. And if someone wants to say persons with disabilities can't do any good work, they will say no because they have tried you and you were okay. Mavis, an individual participant, cited as NAMI 2014. The perceived inability of Ghanaian women with disabilities to fulfill the standards of womanhood also contributes to many unreported instances of abuse, particularly sexual abuse. Sexual abuse incidents are less likely to be believed and taken seriously because disabled Ghanaian women are perceived to be asexual and lack sexual attraction because they deviate from the normalized body image, cited as Budu Enuson et al. 2019. Most do not seek support services regarding abuse trauma due to the lack of knowledge and awareness of support services. The belief that the abuse is a quote-unquote family matter. Retaliation from the abusing party, rejection and withdrawal of support from family or caregivers, especially if those they depend on is inflicting the abuse. Feelings of fear, not being believed, or being subjected to stereotypes that portray them as quote-unquote useless or as quote-unquote witches. Embarrassment and shame due to the abuse and poor treatment by medical professionals and police. Cited as Budu Enuson et al. 2019. On this slide, here is a photo of mostly female students with disabilities using wheelchairs, crutches, and canes. They are wearing uniforms that are gray wax print dresses with red and green colors and patterned white dots. They attend St. Teresa School for the Physically Challenged at Abor in the Volta region of Ghana. The source of this photo comes from the Modern Ghana website. Motherhood and disability. Many mothers who either have disabilities or have children with disabilities can struggle with providing basic care. In Ghana, mothers have to nurture their babies, but their efficiency comes into question when they are disabled. For disabled Ghanaian mothers, their abilities to play their roles effectively as parents are often doubted by general society and healthcare personnel. Hence, disabled mothers have heightened fears about their abilities to meet the challenges of motherhood. Cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. In addition, breastfeeding is very tangible for mothers in Ghana. This can be a challenge for disabled Ghanaian women who have just given birth due to limited support, disability-related health considerations, and difficulties with milk production and latching, which cause lower rates of breastfeeding. There is also limited information in this context, cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. Ghanaian mothers with disabilities are more likely to develop postpartum depression than mothers without disabilities. They also find it difficult to access reproductive health services because most health facilities do not have the resources to meet their needs. In Ghana, the quality of postnatal healthcare services for women is low. The physical environments of most health facilities are such that they restrict women with disabilities from accessing maternal and child health services, along with inadequate social support for people living with disabilities, cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. On this slide, here is an image of a disabled woman living in the Brong Ahafo region of Ghana. She is sitting on a bench while breastfeeding her son. Her left leg has been amputated. The source of this photo comes from the Dreamtime website. Disabled mothers in Ghana have developed means to breastfeed their children while prioritizing their health needs and capacity in terms of energy. The abbreviation DM stands for Disabled Mother. DM4. I have to always sleep by him to be able to breastfeed. I feel pains in my waist when I sit down, so I cannot breastfeed when I sit. I cannot breastfeed my baby when I cannot find a space where I can lie beside the baby. DM2. Me too, when I sit down for too long to breastfeed, my back hurts. I have to breastfeed for shorter intervals. After every 5 minutes, I have to stop and relax before continuing to breastfeed. DM8. During the early days of breastfeeding, apart from the pain I felt in my nipple, I always felt back pain. Cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. Childcare challenges facing disabled mothers in Ghana are needed assistance to attend to daily activities, access to buildings, mobility, finances, prejudice, and discrimination. DM1. The church I attend. I have a problem, so now I don't go to church. They have built it in such a way that there are steps, and if I get there, I need people to carry me before I can enter the building. And if we close, they are supposed to carry me down. Because they carry me, I don't feel happy to go. So for 4 or 5 months, I have not gone to church. DM1. Sometimes you, the mother, you have to eat so that you get breast milk to feed the child. Maybe by that time, I will not have money because I can't secure any formal job, and the father too has not brought money for me to buy those things. DM8. I carry my child at my back and hold her in place with a cloth anytime I have to descend stairs with her. Once the baby is tied to my back, I use my crutches and calipers to go anywhere with her without any form of assistance. Cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. Child care challenges continued. DM9. Although today the pain is bearable, when I walk a little, I feel a lot of pains in my leg, and that causes me to fall at any time. I fall down without warning all the time. Sometimes when I am carrying my child, I fall down suddenly with her without any warning. Sometimes I fall down at public places. This really causes a lot of embarrassment for me. DM4. It is small. When I gave birth, there was this woman in our house. She used to laugh at me. She used to say, "But this one, if she gives birth, what breast milk will the baby suck?" They'll make jokes about my ability to be a mother, and they will be laughing at me. DM9. Once at the house, my child strayed into the street and a stranger brought her inside. When he came, he met about 5 of us who were women in the house. He went round asking all the women if they were the mother of my child, without asking me. It took the other woman to convince him before he believed that I was the mother of the child. Most people discriminate against me. I cry a lot most of the time due to the way people discriminate against me. Cited as Ichiampong et al. 2020. On this slide, here is a photo of a disabled woman named Aulatu and her family. She is the mother of 5 children and makes soap for a living. Soap can be seen in the footwell of her wheelchair. This photo was taken in Gurugu, the northern region of Ghana. The source of this photo comes from the IFAD, Investing in Rural People. Much like the child care challenges that disabled mothers face, mothers of children with disabilities also face difficulties in providing basic care and disability accommodations for their children. For mothers of children with disabilities, they have to make personal and financial adjustments, develop a new role in giving support to their child, and deal with the daily demands of caregiving, including feeding, dressing, toilet training, as well as management and adaptation to their disability or disabilities. Cited as Oti Boidi, 2017. Some mothers experience varying levels of psychological distress as a result of raising a disabled child. Some of these stressors are sadness, worry about the child's future, demands of caregiving, employment and financial issues, stigma and isolation, cited as Osi Boidi, 2017. My mother once told me as a teenager that when I was a young child and unable to walk, she would become sad and worry about me because she did not know if I'd be able to be quote-unquote independent or whether someone will be able to take care of me. And now she isn't worried about my well-being because I can do many things on my own. Other mothers' statements are similar. For example, that day I found out, I cried. I wasn't happy at all because I have two children, and the first is a girl, and even that I wanted a boy as my first child. And so when I had this boy, I was so excited because that is what I wanted. But when they told me about this situation, I didn't like it. I cried a lot. From Jesse. It was very painful and I cried. After her birth, I decided not to give birth again. So it was really painful that my last child had to have such a condition. From Eve. If you look at him now, that he is almost 8 years, but there are so many things he cannot do for himself. He is not walking, talking, and not able to do anything. So I worry about his future. From Enyoma. I am very worried about his future because at now he can't talk, think, or do anything for himself. And so if God does not help him to get well and I die and leave him, what will he do? Who will take care of him? I used to have house helps, but they were all not treating him well in my absence. So I decided to stop working and concentrate on his care. So his future keeps me very worried. Who will get such time for him? From Grandma. Cited as Oti Boidi, 2017. More examples relating to stress, caregiving, financial issues, stigma, and isolation. I think every parent gets stressed in parenting children, but the stress associated with parenting a child with autism is very intense. She is always running up and down and always shouting, and you need to control her. It can be very stressful. Thinking of all the sacrifices you have to make for her development and how to get her through the daily activities, getting the other disciplines to understand the situation, financing her education, which is more expensive than regular school. It's a whole lot of trouble. From Adessa. I go through a lot on a normal day. In the morning when we wake up, I wake him up and brush the teeth. Brushing his teeth is difficult. I have to sing and crack jokes for him to laugh so that when he opens the mouth, then I can brush. I have to bathe him, dress him, feed him, and virtually do everything for him. The issue is he cannot do anything for himself, so I have to help him out every time. After all these, I have to take him to school myself. From Enyoma. Cited as Otibwedi, 2017. More examples continued. Growing up, I had plans of working and having a fabulous career. But because of my daughter, I had to come to terms with the fact that I will be a caregiver all my life. I cannot work like other women do. I made a decision to stop working as I could not work and also take care of my daughter. From Adessa. I had problems with my employers because I had to leave work in the afternoon to pick my son from school. They would not allow me to do that every afternoon and I had no help. So I had to give up my work and this affected my finances significantly. From Obenewa. It has been a real experience and a very difficult journey of having a child with special needs. In this society, it is a taboo to have and people often say that you have a child with intellectual disability because of something bad you have done. One day, a certain woman in our area insulted me that I have given birth to a dog because of my sins. From Leslie. I cannot take my son out to any social program as I do not like the way other people would look at him. Instead of asking what is wrong with her, they stare at her and I feel bad, so I stay with her in the house when others are attending social programs we could be a part of. From Samuela. Despite these stressors, there are forms of social support that have played a role in mothers having positive experiences and remaining emotionally strong. This includes some familial support in collectivist cultures, faith and spirituality, and support from other families who also have children with disabilities. Cited as Otibwedi, 2017. For example, my mother also used faith in God to help her cope with her stressors related to my apparent disability. Examples include, I am a strong believer in God. So the only thing I know is that God gave her to us, and He knows why He gave her to us. I believe I was chosen by God to have a child with a disability. My daughter had to come to the world but through me. Sometimes I ask God, why me? And a friend once said, why not you? I believe God wanted this child to come into the world, and He had to choose me. I believe it is a calling. From Adessa. Sometimes I feel I am in charge and can carry all the burdens alone. But there comes a point when you realize that it is only by the grace of God that you can survive. From Merrill. I usually do prayers and understanding and knowing the Lord you serve, knowing what He can do for me encourages me. I mostly pray for direction, and I always go to the church programs in order to feel relieved. The prayers do help, but most often, though, we pray in awe, but just the thought of being in this state is a great worry. I think in every situation, things happen to us, and you ask God, why me? But I think the first thing to do is to accept it so you know how to handle it. From Samuela, cited as Oti Boydi, 2017. On this slide, here is a photo of an NGO called Smiles for Speech, SFS, and mothers with their children who have developmental disabilities. The source of this photo is from News Ghana website. Apart from faith and spirituality, mothers express hope in some support that is given to them and their children. For example, I know God will make him become somebody in the future. I will not give up because there is hope. From Samuela. There is hope for the future because since she started school, she has really improved. And I'm so thankful to God that we did not abandon her. From Adesa. My husband helps a lot. Days when I'm not able to take her to school, he does it. And even at home, he helps with taking care of the home. He is very supportive. From Adesa. I have a good friend in Kumasi, whom I usually call when I'm stressed. For the family, they always come in to help, especially when I have to go for a course abroad. At church too, there is one Sunday school teacher who supports us, helps my daughter to fit into her class at church, and protects her from children who might be rude to her. From Samuela. My church members and pastor are a very strong source of support. They visit us and also give us some financial support whenever they can. I really appreciate this. From Grandma. The school also helps a lot because they organize programs for us on how to handle our children and how to cope. They encourage us anytime we are sad that everything will be well. From Enyoma. Cited as Oti Boydi, 2017. Yet, due to the pervasive stigma surrounding disability, familial and societal support is very limited to an extent. My parents, for instance, had limited familial support when it came to raising me. Examples include, the family is not helping. My husband has passed on, and the sister once said, quote unquote, we know about your situation, but we also have children to take care of. Unfortunately, my parents have also passed, so I really do not have anybody who is providing support for us. From Jesse. One day at church, he urinated on himself, and one woman said, quote unquote, an old boy like you, why should you urinate on yourself? But I got bored about it and told her that the child has a problem. There is also a woman at church who tells everybody who comes to the church for the first time about my grandson's condition. But one day I confronted her and told her that instead of telling people about the child, she should pray for him. From Grandma. She urinated on herself one time and a nurse shouted at her, how can a big girl like you urinate on yourself? I think that was extreme coming from a health professional. From Adesa. Cited as Oti Boydi, 2017. On this slide, here is a picture of a community nurse delivering healthcare to a baby amid the COVID-19 pandemic. The source of this photo comes from the World Health Organization Africa Region website. Healthcare in Ghana. Over the years, healthcare has improved in Ghana, particularly in the maternal health sector. However, maternal health is still of serious concern. According to the World Health Organization, WHO, maternal mortality in Ghana accounts for 14% of deaths among females between the ages of 12 and 49 years as of 2016, and is the second largest cause of female mortality after infectious diseases among women of childbearing age, cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. Even though there has been a free maternal health care policy in place since 2003, almost 50% of births occur at home without any form of skilled care, cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. Some Ghanaian disabled women have stated they find difficulty accessing quality maternal health care because of mobility issues, limited support, communication problems, inaccessible health care, infrastructure, health care providers' insensitivity, and lack of knowledge, cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. There is a desire for childbirth and skilled care, but as a result of these issues mentioned, the health of expectant mothers can be badly affected, cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. On this slide, here is a photo of a disabled woman and her two children on her lap. She is sitting in her wheelchair. The source of this photo comes from the Center for Employment of Persons with Disabilities of Ghana, CEPD, Facebook page. Some examples of some experiences. When I was pregnant, I wanted to go to the hospital to see the midwife, but because of my condition, I couldn't go. I really want to go and check my pregnancy. My problem is how to move from here to the health center. I can't paddle my wheelchair to the health center because it is far. If I had enough money, I would just hire a taxi to take me there. I can't also use the public bus because I can't get into the bus. And even if I get somebody to help me into the bus, where to put my wheelchair is a problem. It is not that I don't want to go for antenatal. My problem is, you know, I can't move alone without support, and people are very reluctant to help me. They normally say if I knew I couldn't walk to the clinic, then I shouldn't have gotten pregnant. I delivered my first child at home because I didn't get good support from my family, because my husband had traveled and my mother too was ill. But for this second one, I delivered in the hospital because my first child took care of me while I stayed in the hospital. Last time, I went to the clinic to complain to the midwife about some pains I felt around my waist. But the midwife couldn't understand what I was talking about. She just gave me paracetamol and asked me to go home. Cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. Some statements, examples continued. It is frustrating to go to the clinic. Nobody seems to understand me. When I go with my husband, It is better because he understands me, and he then tells the nurses what I am saying. But if I go alone, they don't understand me. If I go to the hospital now, how to get inside will be a problem. The entrance has a steep staircase that I can't climb with my wheelchair. Some of the offices too, I can't enter with my wheelchair. It takes longer before the nurses will help you enter. The last time I went to check my pregnancy, I waited for almost 30 minutes. As I can't see, it is always difficult to find my way around, especially if my husband is not around to help me. The health people too, they won't help you. The last time I went, I almost tripped off the stairs. So these are some of the problems I face. One time when I was pregnant, I went to see the midwife. As soon as I got to the health center, one of the nurses shouted to her colleagues, "Come and see a pregnant cripple." I felt really embarrassed. Since that day, I have not been to the health center. Cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. I think most of the nurses just don't understand that as a disabled person, we have special needs. The other day, I went to see the midwife. She just asked me to lie on the table. But the table was high. When I asked one of the nurses to help me, she just started shouting at me. She said, "Why couldn't I climb and lie down myself?" She didn't seem to understand that I couldn't stand on my own. She even said, "If I knew I couldn't climb the table, then I shouldn't have been pregnant." She also said it wasn't her job to be helping cripples lie down on tables. I really felt bad. Sometimes the nurses don't really think about my situation. When I was pregnant and went for checkup, the nurse said I should do exercise by walking every day. But look at me. I can't stand and walk. I can only move about in this wheelchair. So how do I benefit from this advice? At times, you can tell that the nurses don't want to help you. Sometimes, too, they are just afraid of you, like you're a lion waiting to eat them up. But it's not like that. I'm a human being with feelings, so when I go to see the nurse and they treat me like an animal, I won't go again. Cited as Ghanaian et al. 2016. On this slide, here is a picture of various disabled women in Ghana in a march on International Women's Day. Hashtag Leave No Woman Behind. Hashtag IWD 2021. The source of this photo comes from the Global Call to Action Against Poverty website. Do Ghanaian women with disabilities have a good quality of life in Ghana? If an answer was given from a generalized standpoint, this would be a clear no. The quality of life of Ghanaian women with disabilities is affected by social and environmental barriers such as stigmatization and ostracization, lack of accessibility and support, education and work opportunities, as well as lack of sensitivity and knowledge of various disabilities. However, this also depends on individual experiences and circumstances and can vary from person to person. Do the attitudes and perceptions towards disability affect how a Ghanaian woman manages her health needs and quality of life? Yes. The attitudes and perceptions towards disability have a direct link to how a Ghanaian woman manages her health needs and quality of life, disabled and non-disabled women alike. The attitudes and perceptions have a role in whether a Ghanaian woman will receive support services, that is, disability accommodations, healthcare services, and/or economic assistance, educational and work opportunities for herself if she has a disability or chronic health issues, or for her child who may have a disability. This is because the attitudes and perceptions towards disability can range from pity, annoyance, anger, misunderstanding and ignorance, superstitious belief, skepticism of ability, and more. If more people around the world were open to learning about various disabilities, their symptoms, and possible options for support, both medical and personal, more women and disabled people overall can have a better quality of life. Here are my references. And my image references as well. Whoever is listening to this presentation, thank you very much for listening, and I hope that you were able to learn something out of the information I just provided. Thank you very much.